Hi dear students, welcome back to Gurudev online classes. So in the last class of 8 maths, we are discussing on the chapter that is understanding quadrilaterals, right? So in the last class, we had learned about the two properties of a parallelogram, right? So in that, what is the first property? The opposite sides of a parallelogram are of equal length. So what is the first property of a parallelogram? The opposite sides of a parallelogram are of equal length. Then what is the second property of a parallelogram? And the opposite angles of a parallelogram are of equal measure. So this is about the first and second property of a parallelogram. We had already solved some of the exemplary problems of property 1. So in the last class we had learned the property 2, but we didn't have solved the problems based on that property. So in today's class, we shall solve the problems based on the property 2. Okay? So this is the problem based on the property 2. So once I will repeat what is the second property says. The opposite angles of a parallelogram are of equal measure. Clear? So here, what is the first question in the property second? In figure. So this is the figure that I have given. This is a parallelogram. So in figure, BEST is a parallelogram. Find the values of X, Y and Z. Okay. Here they had given the parallelogram named as BEST. Okay. So they are asking to find the value of X, Y and Z. They had only given the measure of one angle, that is angle B, that is 100 degree. Right. So we have to find the values of X, Y and Z. So now we shall find the value of X, Y and Z. See, first, according to our property 2, okay, the opposite angles of a parallelogram are of equal measure. So for B, B is given 100 degree. So for angle B, which is the opposite angle? The opposite angle of angle B is opposite angle. Hence the value of X is 100 degree. Because you already know that by the property, the opposite angles of a parallelogram are of equal measure. Okay. So, angle S is equal to angle B. Okay. Angle S is equal to angle B. Why? Opposite angles are equal measure due to the second property. And what we can write? Angle S is equal to angle B is equal to 100. Because already we know angle B is equal to 100. Then angle S is also equal to angle B. Hence, X value of X is also 100. Right? So, X is also equal to 100. So, in the place of X, we can substitute 100. Clear? Next. Next, we have to find the value of Y and Z. Okay, now you came to know the value of X, that is 100 degree. Right? It is 100, you came to know now. Now, already discussed about corresponding angles, adjacent angles and also the opposite angles, right? So, let's recall that. See, if there are two parallel lines and if a line is passes through or cut these two parallel lines, this is called as a transverse line. So, here there is a formation of opposite angles. What are the opposite angles here? See, for angle A, angle B is opposite, right? See, for angle C, angle D is opposite, right? So, these are called as the opposite angles. Then, what is our corresponding angles? See, this angle and this angle are called as the corresponding angles. Why they are called as the corresponding angles? Corresponding angles means they have to face at one side. See, they have to face at one side. See, if there is a person here, if there is a person here, let us think or imagine, here is a person. So, to look at this person, these two are looking at the same side, right? So, this angle is also looking at this person and this angle is also looking at this person. Means, the angles which are on one side or facing on one side, the angles which are facing on one side are called as corresponding angles. So, these two are called corresponding angles. This is angle A and angle B. These two are called corresponding angles. Again, this angle, angle C and angle D are also corresponding angles, right? See, if there is a person here, C and D angle D here. So both are facing on one side. So they are facing on one side. The arc bond has a corresponding angles. Clear? So in this parallelogram, this DS and BE are the two parallel lines, and this SE is a transverse line. Okay? See, I will take these two. That is TS and BE are the two parallel lines, and this SE is a transverse line. So here there is a formation of corresponding angles. That is this angle and this angle. These two are looking at one side, right? They are facing on one side, hence these two are called corresponding angles. This is X angle, this is Y angle, right? So this X and Y angle are facing on one side, hence these two are called as a corresponding angles. So X is equal to Y. You already know that corresponding angles are equal. So angle X is equal to angle Y. We already know the value of X is 100, then Y is also 100, right? So if X is 100, the corresponding angle of X is Y, it is also equal to 100, right? This is also equal to 100 degree. Clear? So now you came to know about the two angles, that is angle X is equal to 100 degree, Y is equal to 100 degree. Now we know that the sum of linear pair is equal to 180 degree. So this is a straight line. The sum of these two angles will be equal to 180 degree. You already know that linear pair is equal to 180 degree. So Y plus Z is equal to 180. Yes, Y plus Z is equal to 180 due to the linear pairs. Those two are the linear pairs. Sum of linear pair is equal to 180 degree. So now we already know the value of Y, that is 100 degree, plus Z is equal to 180 degree. So Z is equal to 180. I will send this 100 to the right. It becomes minus 100. So 180 minus 100 is 80 degree. So Z is equal to how much? Z is equal to 80 degree. Clear? So now you have found the value of X, Y and Z. Clear? So this is about the first problem in the property 2. See, once again I will repeat. In figure, they had given a figure, okay, BEST is a parallelogram. They had given the measure of only the one angle. They are asking to find the value of X, Y and Z. How you can find that? First, the opposite angle of angle B is angle S. Yes, the second property, what the second property says? The opposite angles of a parallelogram are of equal measure. So for angle B, angle S is the opposite angle. Hence these two will be equal. Angle B is equal to angle S is equal to 100 degree. Right? So both are equal to 100 degree. Hence X is equal to 100. Right? So then we have found the value of X. For X, Y is the corresponding angle. I said you what is the corresponding angle? The angles which are facing on one side. So X and Y are facing on one side. Hence we call these two as the corresponding angles. So they are equal. So if X is 100, Y is also 100. Now you put the value of X and Y. Now how you can find the value of Z? You already know that the angle on the straight line is equal to 180 degree. Yes. Here sum of Y angle plus Z angle will be equal to 180 degree. So Y plus Z is equal to 180. We already know the value of Y, that is 100. So 100 plus Z is equal to 180 due to linear pairs. Then Z is equal to 180 minus 100, that is Z is equal to 80 degree. So the value of X is 100 degree, Y is 100 degree, Z is 80 degree. So this is about the first problem in the property 2. Yes. Now the third property of a parallelogram. So what is the third property of a parallelogram? The statement of the third property of the parallelogram is the adjacent angles in a parallelogram are supplementary. So what is the meaning of the supplementary? The angles will be equal to 180 degree. So what they are saying, the adjacent angles in a parallelogram are supplementary. Means the sum of the adjacent angles will be equal to 180 degree. Supplementary means 180 degree. So what are the adjacent angles? Adjacent means neighboring. Here for angle A, angle B is the neighboring and angle D is the neighboring. Right? For angle B, A is the neighboring and C is the neighboring. For angle 180 degree. Okay, equal to 180 degree. So the adjacent angles will be equal to 180 degree. The adjacent angles in a parallelogram are supplementary, means the two angles, the sum of two adjacent angles will be equal to 180 degree. And also we can write angle A plus angle D. These two are the adjacent angles. A and B are the adjacent. So A and B will be equal to 180 degree. Okay, the two adjacent angles will be equal to supplementary, or the adjacent angles of a parallelogram will be equal to 180 degree, means supplementary, right? See, again for a B, for B, for angle B, angle C is the adjacent, right? So they are, the sum of those B and C will be equal to 180 degree. In the same, angle C plus angle D, C and D are the adjacent, they are equal to 180 degree. In this way you will get the adjacent angles, and the property says the adjacent angle of a parallelogram are supplementary. Adjacent angle of a parallelogram are supplementary. For A, B is also adjacent, D is also adjacent. So A plus B is equal to 180 degree, or A plus D is equal to 180 degree. This is the property. There is no proof for this property. They have given the statement directly. The adjacent angles in a parallelogram are supplementary, means the sum of the two adjacent angles will be equal to 180 degree. Next, the example question given, okay, on this property is, in a parallelogram RING, if measure of angle R is equal to 70 degree, find all the other angles. They had given a parallelogram RING, okay. So they had given the measure of only the one angle, that is measure of R is equal to 70 degree. We have to find the other angles, that is angle I, angle N and angle G. So first, measure of angle R will be equal to measure of angle N, right? Why they are equal? Because they are opposite angles. Due to the second property, what the second property says? The opposite angle of a parallelogram are of equal measure. So hence this is also 70 degree, right? So measure of angle R is equal to 70 degree. They had given. So measure of angle R is equal to measure of angle N, because they are opposite angles. Okay? Due to the property second. So those two will be equal to 70 degree. Clear? Now we have to use the property third. What is the third property? The adjacent angles of a parallelogram are supplementary. So for angle R, angle I is the adjacent, right? Or angle G is also adjacent, but I will take now here I is the adjacent of R. Measure of angle R plus measure of angle I is equal to 180 degree. Why it is equal to 180? Due to the third property, adjacent angles of a parallelogram are supplementary. So is equal to 180. So already we know the measure of angle R, they had given 70 degree. So 70 degree plus measure of angle I is equal to 180 degree. I will set the 70 degree to the right. What it becomes? Minus 70 degree. So measure of angle I is equal to 180 minus 70, 110 degree. So you already got the value of measure of angle I, that is equal to 110 degree. Again, we can use the third property, or we can use the second property. So I will use the second property. What is the second property? Opposite angles of a parallelogram are equal. Hence, for angle I, angle G is a opposite angle, right? Hence, the measure of those two angles will be equal. Hence, if the measure of angle I is 110 degree, then what is the measure of angle Z? Angle G. It is also 110 degree, right? See, measure of angle I is equal to measure of angle G. Why? Second property. Opposite angles of a parallelogram are equal. So measure of angle G is equal to 110 degree. Yes? Completed. So what they are asked? Find all the other angles. We had found the other angles. Clear? So this is about the third property, and also the problem based on the third property. Clear? So what they are asked? They had given the measure of one angle. They are asking to find the remaining angle. They had given only the measure of R. For R, angle N is a 110 degree. So now you have got the measure of angle I. Measure of angle I. So if you came to know about the measure of angle I, easily we can find the measure of angle G. Okay? How? Because these two angles are opposite angles, they are equal. So if this is 110, this is also 110 degree. Clear? We have found the values of all the other angles. So this is about the third property and the problem based on the third property. Clear? Yes. Now we shall discuss about the fourth property of a parallelogram. The statement of the fourth property of a parallelogram is the diagonals of a parallelogram bisect each other. What do you mean by bisect? See, if there are two diagonals, you already know how the diagonals are formed, right? We had learned this in our previous classes. So when you draw two diagonals, when these two diagonals intersect at a point O, they bisect each other, they are saying. Okay? Bisect means then make the two diagonals into two equal halves. Okay? See, this diagonal, okay, makes the diagonal BD into two equal parts. Right? And this diagonal BD makes this diagonal AC into two equal parts. Clear? Bisect means they will make one diagonal makes the other diagonal into two equal halves. Okay? For example, here AC is a diagonal which makes BD into two equal halves. Okay? And BD is a diagonal which makes the AC into two equal halves. Okay? They will make the equal halves of one each other. Okay? This is called as a bisect. So what they are saying, the diagonals of the parallelogram bisect each other. Bisect means they will make the one other into the equal halves. They will cut the diagonals into equal halves. What do you mean by equal halves? See, if this AC is a 4 cm, BD is a line or a diagonal which bisect this AC into two equal halves. Means here 2 cm and here 2 cm. Clear? So this is the meaning of bisect each other. So we have to prove that the diagonals of a parallelogram bisect each other. Means they will make AC into OA equal to OC. They will make them equal parts. And OD will be equal to BO. We have to prove that. So given ABCD is a parallelogram. To prove, what we have to prove? OA is equal to OC. Okay? BO is equal to OD. Means the diagonals will intersect each other and they will bisect each other. Okay, when they intersect each other, they will bisect them each other. Bisect means they will make the other into the equal halves. So we have to prove that. Construction. Diagonal AC and BD. You have to construct the diagonal AC and BD in a parallelogram ABCD. Proof. How you can prove this? See, when the two diagonals intersect at a point O, you will get the two triangles. What are those two triangles? AOB and COD. These two are the triangles we get when you bisect the two diagonals. Okay? So these two are the triangles AOB and COD. Okay? Clear? You already learnt in the previous class about the alternative angles, right? AB and CD are the parallel lines. If you draw a diagonal here, that is AC, you will get the two alternative angles here. This is angle 1 and this is angle 2. Right? These two are equal. Again, when you draw one more diagonal here, that is BD. Okay? Again, here it is 4 and here it is 3. Right? So, these two are equal. These two are equal and these two angles are equal. So, angle 1 is equal to angle 2, angle 3 is equal to angle 4. Why they are equal? Alternative interior angles. Clear? This is a parallelogram. You know that. This is a parallelogram. By the first property, what you know that? Opposite sides of a parallelogram are equal. Means these two sides are equal and these two sides are equal. Hence, here what we can take? AB is equal to CD. Line segment AB will be equal to line segment CD. Why they are equal? Because they are opposite sides of a parallelogram. Right? So, by these three, we have proved two angles side is equal, right? So by AS congruency we had proved that triangle AOB is congruent to the triangle COD. Clear? So this is about the congruency of two triangles. So when the two triangles are congruent, I had taught you in the previous property, when the two triangles are congruent, then the corresponding sides are also equal, right? So what are the corresponding sides of these two triangles? AO is corresponding to OC, right? And BO is corresponding to OD, right? So these two are equal and these two are equal. Why they are equal? Corresponding sides. I already learned this, right? See, if two triangles are like this, okay, ABCD and PQR, if you think these two triangles are equal, if these two triangles are congruent, then the corresponding parts are also equal. Meaning of that is the corresponding sides and this side are equal, and these sides are equal, and this side are equal, right? And corresponding angles are also equal. These two are the corresponding angles, these two are the corresponding angles, these two are the corresponding angles. The corresponding parts of congruent triangles are equal. Hence, what we can say? AO is a corresponding side of OC in this triangle and OD is the corresponding side of this triangle OB. Clear? So, what we can conclude? AO is equal to CO and BO is equal to DO by CPCT. CPCT means corresponding parts of a congruent triangle. So these are the corresponding sides of a congruent triangles. Clear? We have proved that the diagonals of a parallelogram bisect each other. Bisect means they will make the diagonals into equal halves. Equal halves of AC is AO is equal to OC. How the BD is made into equal halves? OB is equal to OD. So this is about the fourth property. That we should solve the problem based on this fourth property. Yes, what is the problem given based on this fourth property? HEP is a parallelogram. Given that OE is equal to 4 cm and HL is 5 more than the PE. Find OH. So here there is a parallelogram HELP. Right? So here there is a diagonals HL and PE, which bisect each other. Clear? They had given the value of OE. They had given the value of OE line. Okay? OE is equal to 4 cm. Okay? OE is equal to 4 cm. They had given. We know that OE is equal to OP. Why these two are equal? Because the diagonal HL bisect this diagonal PE into two equal halves. By the property, the diagonals of a parallelogram bisect each other, we can say that HL is a diagonal, PE is a diagonal. When they bisect each other, they make the equal halves. This PE is made into equal halves by this diagonal HL. So if this is 4 cm, this is also 4 cm. Right? They are equal. Why they are equal? HL is a diagonal which bisect them. Bisect means make into the two equal halves. So if OE is equal to 4 cm, OE is equal to OP, which is also equal to 4 cm. So now you got OP is also 4 cm. Then what they had given in the question? HL is 5 more than PE. This whole diagonal HL is 5 times more than the PE. PE. So to get PE, what we have to do? PE is equal to OE plus OP. Right? So we already know the value of OE and also OP. So OE is 4 cm. They had given. OP is a 4 cm. We had found. When you add them, you will get PE. Total length of this diagonal. So PE is equal to 8 cm. So PE is equal to 8 cm. Clear? Now you got PE. Now what they have given in the question? HL is 5 more than PE. HL is 5 times the PE. 5 times the PE OH and OL. So this OH will be half of the HL, right? See, this is HL. Okay, this is HL. So this HL is divided into two equal parts by the diagonal PE, right? By the diagonal PE, it is divided into two equal halves. Now we have found the value of HL. HL total how much you get? 13 cm. This is 13 cm. Then what is this OH? This, how much this is? This is half of the HL, right? Half of this total length, HL. So half of HL. Half into HL, you have found that HL is equal to 13. So when you substitute the value of HL, that is 13 cm, half into 13 is equal to 6.5 cm. So OH is equal to 6.5 cm and OL is equal to 6.5 cm, right? So total HL is equal to 13 cm. Clear? Now you have found the value of OH, that is 6.5 cm. So this is the problem based on this fourth property. Okay, once again I will repeat. According to our property, the diagonals of a parallelogram bisect each other. Means when the two diagonals intersect at a point, they will divide each other into the equal halves. They have given a problem. HELP is a parallelogram. Okay. Given that OE, they have given only the value of OE, that is 4 cm. And HL is more than PE by 5 times. 5 more than PE. Find OH. See, they had given OE is equal to 4 cm. OE is a 4 cm. Then what is the value of OP? It is also 4 cm. Because this diagonal HL bisect this PE diagonal into two equal halves. Hence, if this is 4 cm, this is also 4 cm. Yes. So, OP is also 4 cm. Then what is OP plus OE? When you add them, you will get total diagonal, that is PE. So PE is equal to OE plus OP, that is 4 plus 4, that is 8 cm. In the question I have given, HL is 5 more than PE. Means HL is equal to 5 more than PE, that is 5 plus PE. You already came to know the value of PE, that is 8 cm. So 5 plus 8 is 13 cm. So HL is equal to 13 cm. So now we want the value of OH. OH is the half of the length of HL, right? Because this is a diagonal, HL is a diagonal. PE divides this HL into two equal halves. Hence OH, one part of HL will be equal to half the total length. So half into HL. Value of HL is 13 cm. So half into 13 is 6.5 cm. So now you have found the value of OH is equal to 6.5 cm. Clear? So this is about the all the four properties of a parallelogram. So in the next class, we should solve the exercise 4.3 and we should move to the next type of or next kind of parallelogram, that is rhombus. Clear? So this is about the today's class. We shall meet in the next class. Thank you.